Hi, and welcome to this vSAN 6.7 Update 1 demonstration. Today I'm going to show you a cool feature which is called Quick Start. And this feature actually comes into play after you've created a cluster. So what we're going to do first is we're going to create a cluster which is called 6.7 Update 1. We're going to enable DRS, HA, and vSAN, and then the Quick Start function will start popping up. And this Quick Start function is a new interface to actually create the cluster and add all of the additional services to the cluster. On top of that, you can, for instance, also add all of the hosts to your cluster. So in this particular case, we're going to add 8 hosts to the cluster. We're going to set one host aside because that's the host we're going to use as a vSAN witness. So we're going to use that later on in the demo. So after we've added these 8 hosts to the cluster, and these were 8 existing hosts, you can notice that these hosts were added into the cluster into maintenance mode. So before we can start using them, we may want to finish some of the other parts of the configuration first. And I like this particular aspect, the fact that it's added into maintenance mode, because it removes some of the risks of the hosts immediately being used by a workload. So after we've added them, you can see a whole list of different checks. Fortunate for us, most of them were green, so we can continue and go ahead and start configuring the network. We're going to configure the vMotion network, and we're going to configure the vSAN network. So in this particular case, we're going to select a couple of physical adapters. The physical adapters are going to be added to the distributed switch. And after that, we're going to set the particular port group. In this particular case, we don't need to specify anything particular. We're going to use DHCP and just a regular VLAN. And then the network configuration is done. However, we will need to do the configuration of the Stretch cluster interface. So that's also something we're going to do in this particular demo. We're also going to enable deduplication and compression. So after this, we're going to claim the disks, the vSAN disks, the caching disks, and the capacity the tier. In our case, we have an all-flash cluster, so 8 hosts with in total 2.3 terabytes worth of flash capacity. We're going to select the capacity disks, and we're going to select the caching disks, and we'll be able to claim those disks later on. After that, we simply need to configure the fault domains. And the fault domains, in this particular case, are 2 different sites. So we have 2 different locations. So we're going to stretch our vSAN data store across those locations simply by selecting the host. And this is literally all that it takes. Well, there's one more thing that we need to do, and that's selecting the witness host. So we have this single host set aside, as I previously said. And we're going to select that as a witness host. After selecting it as a witness host, we also need to claim some disks for that particular host, because we also need to have capacity available to store the witness components. And after selecting the caching disk and the various capacity disks, that is basically what we need to do in order to create this particular cluster. So what have we just seen? Well, it is something that is fairly straightforward, but it's rather unique, because in a couple of minutes, we were capable of actually creating a cluster, validating the health of the cluster, and enabling all of the different additional services that we would like to have enabled. So you could see that there was a particular section for DRS, there was a particular section for HA, but on top of that, we were also capable of, for instance, configuring stretch clustering from a vSAN perspective and enable all of the different network services required to run a cluster like this. And with that, we've reached the end of the demo. Hopefully it was useful, and I hope to see you soon in the near future. Thanks for watching.